when you're driving an 80,000 pound missile down the interstate, you've got to be on the top of your game at all times, because the risk to the public and the risk to everybody on the road is so great that we can't afford to let that happen.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to another episode of Ask the Lawyer. Today, we're talking about trucking accidents. Specifically, what are the most common causes of trucking accidents? And we have Grant Lawson of Metier Law Firm here with us today to answer some of those questions. Thanks for being here, Grant.
Yeah, thank you for having me.
Grant, I know you're part of the law firm in Casper, Wyoming, but you have offices all throughout Colorado as well. And I'm sure you've seen so many of these trucking cases. I want to know, what is the most common cause of trucking accidents these days from your perspective?
Boy, I think we're seeing a lot of just inattentive drivers, drivers who may be either tired or distracted with whether it be a handheld device or eating or some other form of a distraction that causes them to not pay attention to what's going on in front of them or around them. And that's causing a lot of severe, serious accidents on our interstates here in the Rocky Mountain region.
And how often do you see it that drivers are actually just kind of skirting the laws in the trucking industry, mainly because of lack of pay or something of that nature?
Well, it's true that, you know, drivers are motivated to drive as far as they can and as long as they can. Now, there's hours of service requirements that try to keep a cap on that. But unfortunately, there's a smaller percentage of drivers and companies that either try to work around that or not adhere to it at all. And that causes drivers to be out there on the road driving tired and not doing their best. And when you're driving an 80,000 pound missile down the interstate, you've got to be on the top of your game at all times, because the risk to the public and the risk to everybody on the road is so great that we can't afford to let that happen.
Yeah, we hear a lot about fatigue of drivers being the cause of a lot of issues. But what about other issues like drug use or alcohol, those types of things that can cause drivers to be more exhausted? Is that popular in the industry?
You know, thankfully, with the testing requirements, most motor carriers and most drivers are out there trying to do the right thing. They're trying not to use drugs or alcohol. And I would say the stark majority of them do not. But of course, you always have the unfortunate few or percentage that choose to do that. And that is exceptionally dangerous. There's just no room for that, no place in our society for anybody behind the wheel of a big rig to be using drugs or alcohol.
You see these cases and they come across your desk so commonly, and you see the trends in the industry. So it may seem like a no-brainer question, but for a lot of us who are new to it and on the driver's side of it in normal vehicles, what's the first thing you should do if you're in a trucking accident?
Yeah, absolutely. There's so much new technology with regard to cameras, tracking, and ways that, you know, motor carriers and companies are making sure that their drivers are staying on schedule, that they're tracking their speed limits, that things are being watched by some companies in a main office. So why it's so important to contact a lawyer at the very onset of being in an accident is because all of that information and all that evidence has to be preserved. And those getting a lawyer on board immediately gets those letters out, gets that information out to say, hey, this is information and evidence that we're going to be collecting. You have a duty to hold on to it, protect it, and make sure that we can get our hands on to look at it. And so that's one aspect. Of course, the most important thing is when somebody's hurt in an accident that they're getting the medical care they need and getting help. But at the same time, a lot of people don't even know how serious their injuries are for weeks or sometimes months to come. And so it's always important that if you are involved in an accident, especially with a big rig, with a motor carrier, that you got to contact a lawyer who knows what they're doing, who is versed in the Federal Motor Carrier Safety Administration and the regs that apply to all the big rigs out there, and making sure that they know how to handle a case, what to be asking for, what to be asking to have preserved, and pushing your case forward to get you the maximum justice that you deserve.
Most commonly, do you end up suing the driver of the big rig involved in the accident or the company behind it or both?
You know, it depends. And that's a great question. There's a lot of state-specific law that applies depending on what state you're dealing with. And it also depends on what we know from the onset of a lawsuit, whether a driver was acting in a way that that could have been his own fault, or whether he was pushed by a company to drive too long and too far. And there's other responsibility there. But there's also information that you really can't get until you get the case going regarding who was the broker, who dispatched, who was involved with the load, and whether there's other players involved. And so typically I would say the driver is included in the case, because a lot of times drivers can be independent contractors that aren't necessarily deemed employees. And so until all that information is found out and it comes out in the lawsuit itself, that it's safer that most of the time the driver is added as a party. And then that sometimes can change as things go down the line.
Do you find that a lot of people are nervous about not being able to afford a lawyer in the first place, especially if they're going through some injuries?
Yes, I find that especially, we also represent a lot of truck drivers, a lot of professional over-the-road drivers who are involved in accidents themselves with other truck drivers, especially on the interstates. And they commonly are concerned that, I don't have the money to afford an attorney. What am I going to do? I can't stop working. My life is dependent upon every mile that I'm out there driving these roads. And so it's good to make sure that people know out there that attorneys that do represent those that are injured, especially in these trucking accidents like us, do it on a contingency fee basis, that it doesn't cost them a dime up front, that their costs for the case are covered. And then those things are recouped at the end if there's a result, a successful result.
And that's such a good point. And I would imagine if somebody is seriously hurt and in the hospital, do you usually have family members reach out to you on their behalf initially? How does that work if you have somebody in who's very hurt?
Yeah, absolutely. We deal with a lot of family members in the wrongful death cases, especially that's common. But in those cases where somebody is severely injured and they're hospitalized, possibly for days or weeks without being able to contact anyone, their family members are the ones reaching out to us, finding out, what should I do? What can I do? Can you help us? And that's what we pride ourselves in, is not only jumping on top of that, helping out the family, but trying to give guidance to make sure that a family feels reassured that their loved one's interests are going to be taken care of.
Anything else you'd like to add that I might have missed today?
You know, in this time of need out there with what our country and what this world is facing, you know, there's a lot to be said, a lot of great things to be said about the trucking industry and the truck drivers out there that are doing great things, that are moving supplies for the country that are in need. And the hours of service, which have been set aside by the Federal Motor Carrier Safety Administration, to allow drivers to drive past those regulated hours right now, apply for certain circumstances, those who are actually transporting equipment in need or products in need. But we hope that the companies that aren't transporting those and the drivers that aren't transporting those needs don't take advantage of this to put tired and fatigued and distracted drivers on the road, putting other lives and people's health at risk and in jeopardy. So that's what I'd like to say. And thank you for having me today. I appreciate it.
Grant Lawson with Metier Law Firm. Thank you so much for your time and knowledge today. We really appreciate it. Have a good one.
Thank you.
Thank you too. And I'm Christine Haas. That's it for today's episode of Ask the Lawyer. Choose a lawyer that lawyers choose. Remember, you can find us anytime online at askthelawyers.com.